talk to my little friend!
Hey guys, EMT Rail Fan, and this is going to be our next installment of Knotty Videos. That's Knotty with a K. This installment is going to be the girth hitch. You see a loop of paracord here. This is not the girth hitch knot. This is a knot that we're going to work into here eventually. I'm not going to name it right now, but the girth hitch is a knot to use when you already have your cordage or your rope or whatever tied into a loop. No matter how you tie the loop and close it, it's good for attaching objects, say like a, you know, your monkey fist, you know, attach it to a keychain. You would form a girth hitch around it or whatever, instead of, you know, running your keychain through the ring and snagging this up or whatever. It's just an easy way to attach a monkey fist to a keychain, or, you know, if this would already be permanently mounted somehow, like on the inside of a tent, you wanted to tie something up with it, you could use a girth hitch just as a quick temporary, you know, tie off to hang items from, to keep them off the floor. So what we're going to do, there's different ways to tie the girth hitch. We're going to start with the loose loop of cordage or whatever, say like your monkey fist or whatever. Just imagine this bottom part down here is going to be your monkey fist tied off, and this is going to be the loop end. Different ways you could do it. I forgot to bring a keychain down with me, so we're going to pretend that the hole in this crescent wrench is a key ring. But what you could do is just take the whole bite through the hole in the keychain, and you could either run the whole monkey fist in through this loop that you just made, and then tighten it up. That's what a girth hitch looks like. Or another way you could do that, if you don't want to run all that cordage through, is run your loop in the same way and then pull it down around the rest of your keychain or whatever, and then pull it tight. And that's, again, your girth hitch. Those of you that make paracord bracelets, this may look familiar to you. This is how you start off your cobra weave, a couple other weaves. You know, this is your first tie off onto your buckle, then you run it through the other buckle and down, and then start your weave. This is what is a girth hitch. Doesn't seem like a very important knot or a hitch or whatever at this point in time, but like I said, yeah, we're going to make in time here in this series, we're going to learn how to make this knot and then make a girth hitch that could save your life. So, you know, we're going to work up to more compound knots, I promise. You know, I just want to start off easy. So, also I wanted to say, how many of you have a piece of paracord that you practice with? You know, just a piece of scrap, a couple feet long maybe, that you practice with, you hang it over your toilet paper hanger in your bathroom while you're sitting there thinking, or whatever, you know, you're sitting there watching TV and practicing these knots that we've been going over, that you have learned before. You know, if you're not doing that, you know, get a piece of your scrap, you know, mount the ends off so it doesn't fray, and, you know, just practice some of these knots while you're watching TV or sitting on the throne or whatever. So, again, we're going to get more complex knots, I promise, so stick with us here. Starting off with easy hitches, we're going into bigger things here. So this is EMT Railfan, signing out. There's your girth hitch. Another easy way to do it. That was, just make your loop, take your fingers up through, go out around the loop, and then bring her down around. There's your girth hitch. So, again, EMT Railfan signing out. Practice these knots.